Hi guys, and in this video we will take a look at the new KSP update 1.4. So if you take a look at the Steam community page, which will be in the video description by the way, we can see some new things which were changed. We have now some other translations, but much more interesting it will be if I will show you everything in the game. So let's open up Steam. Say goodbye to all your old KSP installations with mods, and then first new thing are some new loading screens, because now KSP developers from Team Squad are working under the Take-Two Interactive, which you may know from Rockstar game titles like GTA, or 2K games like Mafia, or Private Division, about which I don't know anything. So the menu screen looks the same. But the first problem was when I wanted to change game resolution, the buttons were unresponsive and I had to close the game and set it up from the launcher. So another try, and now with a proper resolution and max graphic preset. And by the way, in the top left corner you can see FPS during the whole video, just to test out the performance, because now the game is running on the newer Unity engine, which should offer better performance, and also there are better particles, which you will see during the re-entry or in the atmosphere around the vessels. But now, let's create a new game, and in the VAB, or Vehicle Assembly Building, we can see the new command pod, which has been redesigned and has RCS thrusters with one small monopropellant tank and a crew capacity of 3 kerbals. Another new thing is that you can change name of different vessel parts, and by the priority will be set the vessel type. I don't know how useful it is, but it is in game now. Other things which are new are the decoupler textures, which I quite like. They look pretty good and modern, so thumbs up for that. Another new part is this RCS texture on it, but this time you can change the texture or look how it will look like. I think that the textures are almost identical as in the mod KV Rocketry, but never mind. We also have other new fuel tanks as well, and now you can see them all side by side, and in each one you can change the look of it. Other new textures are on the fairings as well, but they are much worse than the previous ones in my opinion. And you have 3 colors to choose from, but I don't know for what is useful that black one, maybe for nuclear weapons. Never mind, there are still 3 sizes of fairings for different sizes, nothing new here. So let's build my first rocket in this version, just to test some things. I will use this type of fuel tank, which I don't really like, because I think that the older texture was much better in my opinion, but okay. And by the way, we also have some new small fuel tanks, which you can use probably on some small props. So we are now on the launch pad, and the first thing I have noticed was that I can't see any kerbals on board, and I can't change the camera into the command pod. And on Discord I have noticed that almost everybody has this issue. But I also heard that it will be added in new 1.4.1 version next week with the Making History DLC expansion. But I don't have confirmed this. So the only way how to EVA kerbals is to click to hatch of the command module, and then from this menu do EVA. And as I will do EVA, we can see the new texture of parachute, which I really like. As I'm getting some speed and the engine is running, we can see the new particles and fumes from the nozzle are now much more realistic, so well done squad. And as I'm coming down through the atmosphere, it is good time to test out our new parachutes. On the actual parachute, we can see our flag. And very nice is that I can control where I want to go quite much. Boom. I consider this as a very successful test. Let's continue. Another new thing, which is really nice, is that you can smoothly change view from Vehicle Assembly Building to Space Plane Hangar, and vice versa. Well done, squad. But now, let's do some final testing with parachutes. Level, landing and re-entry from orbit without any protection. During the braking, we can enjoy new sweet thruster particles. And you can see kerbals are quite thermal durable, so they can survive light re-entry through the atmosphere and then land with parachutes. So in conclusion, parachutes are awesome as hell, and you can probably land on Duna without any protection. We have some new textures on fuel tanks and fairings, we can change color of things, new Unity engine with awesome particles and good performance, VAB to SPH smooth switch button, and a new pod. Okay guys, I have to say that trying this new version was quite funny and I really enjoyed it. So if you like this video, then you know what to do. And I will see you in the next one. Bye!